Morning, everybody. Back again at IT Bowl, Toddly Oddly Games. This is my Blazer with 110 axles. This is my truck, my little Jeep.
Explanations vary from a way to electroplate stuff like jewelry to an electrified statue. There's a theory that a load of the batteries were placed inside a religious statue, so when people touch them, if it's true, whoever made it was pretty clever and sneaky. But if it wasn't used for the statue, then what did they need electricity for in 200 BC anyway? Number 5, ancient model aircraft.
Maybe I should show you guys all my vehicles. It's been a while.
My Chevy. They're called the Saqqara bird and the Kalima or Kumbaya artifacts, respectively. The Saqqara bird was excavated in Egypt in 1898. It's made of sycamore and has a wingspan of...
It wasn't supposed to do that.
The bird is said to have been crafted in approximately 200 BC and used as a mast head on the ship, so there are those who think it was better suited to the air than for the sea. In fact, they believe it's a miniature replica of a glider.
Sorry, Douglas are licking himself. Sounds fucking weird.
Because in all honesty, if you built that thing full size, it would look crazy and wouldn't be able to fly. People have tried. Which brings us to the Kalima or Kumbaya artifacts.
Their old truck.
Charm-like objects, which were also found in Colombia. They're from around 1000 CE, and many similar objects can
my
be
diesel.
The Gold Museum in Bogota.
I got a new build coming up, new build idea. Show you guys here in a bit.
Number 4, crystal skulls. Indiana Jones made crystal skulls famous. But like the Ark of the Covenant,
the Holy Grail,
there's a real legend behind these fascinating artifacts. Question is, are they genuine pieces of ancient history, or just a nice little ornament for your mantelpiece?
Makuta, still original.
My four-wheeler. They can be normal human size or smaller, and they're either transparent crystals or cloudy quartz. Some experts think
my truck.
America, so of course, you guessed it. Others believe they are from an alien civilization. One theory goes that the skulls are ancient computers that can record the lives of humans.
Makuta.
However, the presence of skulls in Aztec art as a symbol of regeneration leads people to suspect it's more to do with symbolism than supernatural powers. When they were checked out under an electron microscope, it seems these skulls have been carved using more recent techniques, dating from the 19th century. Stranger still, they come from Germany, far from their American origins, and might actually be a hoax. Because they're so freaky looking, it's easy to assume there's something odd about them. So far, it's been hard to say. Number 3. Voynich manuscript. Perhaps no artifact is as strange as the Voynich manuscript. Found by a rare book dealer in 1912, after who it was named, it stunned experts at first because it was full of strange images and descriptions that appeared...
This was like my first truck I ever designed.
The text was unusual, as if it were written in code, and it had many illustrations of naked ladies and plant life that doesn't exist. Wild stuff, right? Could it have been a record of something extraterrestrial from way back in history? Researchers Nick Astor revealing it was actually a copy of an ancient text that was produced in the Middle Ages. It's still pretty weird. The language in the book was made up of Latin abbreviations and medical words relating to women's health.
My treasure.
Like
my baby treasure.
Might sound strange, but madness was seen as a way to promote good health.
This right here. This is sick. I don't really drive it though, but it's pretty sick. This is my favorite build. I like this one more than all of the builds that I did though.
This sheet of linen seems to show the impression of a man, and many consider it proof of the Son of God. But is it really him, and is the cloth really that old? This is a debate that's been going on for centuries. The cloth is 4.4 meters by 1.1 meters, and shows a tall. He's got various wounds, and the linen is stained red, presumably from blood. The nature of the wounds look like crucifixion marks that have been seen on the wrist, his side, the forehead, torso, and legs. The Roman Catholic Church has watched over the shrouds since 1983.
My favorite truck.
Before that, it was the property of the Royal House of Savoy, who owned it for centuries. It's found in the Royal Chapel of the Cathedral of St. John the Baptist in Turin, Italy. So don't expect to see it anytime soon.
My Bronco. Even though it's not a, oh no, I called it the Bronco.
For your next opportunity. How the image was created is not known. Some believe it's like a photographic process because of the way the image appears when photographed in 1898. So the photographer was surprised when he looked at the negative, the image seemed
strong. This truck dragon gets down, and it's all like factory fucking suspension, dude. This is one of my other favorite monster trucks.
We know that when computers were first invented, they were huge. But somehow the ancients were able to make a small computer thousands
of years
ago.
Maybe I should put all the monster trucks out on the shop floor.
It's an early, very early example of an analog computer, like a slide rule, and it's made from bronze and wood. It was discovered in 1900.
I'm a Bigfoot. But I still want to fix it and do a little bit more things to it. I'm saying I got a couple more builds coming up, a couple more ideas. You've already seen these ones.
Pottery found in the shipwreck. By the 1970s, in-depth studies were taking place about what the anti-skipper mechanism was. Legendary explorer Jacques Cousteau recovered some of the missing pieces, giving experts even more insight into the device. But what did it actually do? The 3,400 Greek characters described on the mechanism's dials and rings show it's supposed to be an astronomical clock, enabling the user to calculate things like
so today, what's going on?
Thanks for watching.
Make some money.
The strangest artifact. Let us know in the comments below.
And then we're going to go buy another truck, and then we're going to put a lift kit on it. I was watching some TV yesterday, and I had an idea. I was like, I'm gonna make all the monster trucks on Monster Jam, but not identical to them, just kind of like it. That way.
In the year 1625, in
Thank you. that's why she's called the Beast. This truck right here, she don't play around. This truck right here, she a beast. Like and subscribe at itbull.com. Todd Loco, IT Bull Games. On YouTube, Facebook. And I don't know, I really have an Instagram. I'm not weird. I just don't have one. I'll come back to you guys shortly with the bill. I'll give you the idea of what it is. It's gonna be kind of like this, but really cool. So, I will get back to you guys in a bit after I design part of it. I will post. Have a good day.